Alright, you guys, ZFR back here once again, and we are finally talking about Witcher Netflix again here on the channel. So it's been a while since my last video about this show, and that's pretty much because, like, I mean, for one, we've been doing a lot of stuff here on the channel, you know, preparing a lot of stuff for this year. I feel like this is going to be a pretty big year for the channel and stuff. But also on top of that, you know, just with the current pandemic that we're in the middle of, the show's production has slowed down a lot. You know, they've had a lot of interruptions, a lot of setbacks. They've had to recast a few people, I believe. And then on top of that, you know, the news cycle for the show has just slowed down. But apparently, we just got another big piece of info for season 2 of The Witcher Netflix, and that's that there's going to be a major death coming up next season. Now, before we get in this video, this will contain spoilers for all Witcher fans, alright? This leak is something big, and it's not something that was in the books, so I'm warning you right now, even if you've read the books, this does still count as a spoiler. But, you know, whether you're interested or not, you've been warned, so just know that going forward into this video. Now, obviously, Witcher Netflix kind of has a rocky past. You know, the show had a lot of drama around it, you know, before coming out. People weren't exactly psyched about a lot of the alterations they were making, about how far they were kind of, you know, going off the beaten path of the actual novels themselves, and even, you know, completely rejecting, you know, at tying the show in with the games at all or anything. People weren't exactly happy about it. However, though, you know, despite a lot of the criticism, even some of it coming from me, you know, season 1 was still pretty good. And don't get me wrong, season 1 had a lot of problems, alright, which I have listed in detail in a couple videos already. However, though, one thing I will say about Witcher Netflix season 1 is it still did feel like The Witcher. It still did a lot of good things. It still did a lot of things right. And if you're willing to look at it as kind of like a standalone thing instead of, you know, comparing it to the books and the games, even though it's kind of hard to do, you know, it wasn't that bad. Like, there was stuff that still needed work, but it was still a pretty solid start. It can be worked on, it, you know, to become better is what I'm saying. However, it seems like the Witcher Netflix crew over there, it seems like they're at it again. Oh my god. So this news we've gotten about season 2, a lot of fans, I can tell, probably aren't exactly happy about it, or aren't going to be happy about when it actually happens. So getting into this little leak that's happened here, now that none of this is confirmed, I just want to throw that out there. At least from what I'm seeing, none of it looks like it's confirmed to be true yet. It's all still a rumor, but I believe there's a source from the actual set itself that leaked this or whatever. It's all over news sites and stuff, so we're going to be just talking about it here. So apparently, in season 2 of The Witcher Netflix, the Witcher from the School of the Wolves, Eskel, aka Geralt's childhood friend, or Geralt's best friend since childhood or whatever, is going to die in season 2 in a fight with a lesson. Now, there's already a lot of problems, but before we get into them, it gets even worse, because then it goes on to read that apparently during a funeral ceremony in which Henry Cavill and the actor that's playing Lambert were present, apparently they fed Eskel's body to the wolves as a send-off funeral type ceremony deal for Eskel. So I mean, I don't know, I just don't know, guys. So let's go ahead and get into all the obvious problems that a lot of Witcher fans are going to have with this. Now, right off the bat, I know a lot of people are going to be directly upset about Esco dying in season two, but he wasn't a major, major character in the books from what I've seen. I'm only on Tower of Swallows. I haven't finished the books yet. So, I mean, there might be more to him there, but from what I've read so far, which seems to be most of the books at this point, he doesn't seem like he's going to be a huge character. But, you know, in terms of story and lore, I think a lot of people would have liked to see more of him. So I think a lot of people are going to be disappointed the show decided to cut his character even shorter rather than expand on him a lot more. You know, I think a lot of people would have liked to had if one change that people probably would have loved for Witcher Netflix to make is to actually add in more of the other witches like Lambert, Esco, and Vesemir, but looks like they're going to be cutting one of them off short here already. So anyway, you know, if you can get past that part, there's still a lot of problems here. First off, Esco dying to a lesson, I just don't know about that. Like, you're telling me these witches have been alive this long and a lesson is finally what does him in? I don't know, guys. I just don't know how I feel about that one. I mean, I guess it is one of the more dangerous monsters in the world of the Witcher, so I guess that's not too bad. But at the same time, I mean, I don't know. I would have liked to have seen a bit more of an epic death with him, especially since one of the big themes in The Witcher is that the real monsters are men, not actual monsters. So I probably would have actually really liked to have seen them go more of that kind of route with it. But I don't know. Who knows? We'll see. There's multiple villains coming up that they could have given the death to, but they decided to do it with a lesson. So, I mean, I don't know. But anyway, getting past that part, you know, the big part that I feel like is going to hit a lot of fans the wrong way is the whole funeral with him being fed to the wolves. I feel like a lot of fans are not going to be happy about this. And I'm not happy about it because it's just a straight no. Okay, right off the bat, guys, that's a no from me. And I feel like that's going to be a no from a lot of our fans. For a simple reason, in both the books, the games, no matter what you look at, I know they keep saying that that the show is, you know, its own separate adaption, something more unique. It's not just going to adapt everything from those. At the same time, even on the show, I can't see the Witcher characters. I can't see Geralt and Lambert and Vesemir being the type of characters that would engage in this kind of ritual. You know what I'm saying? I just can't see it. Like, they're extremely moral characters despite, you know, their hard exteriors. You know, they're very moral people. You know, that's one really big element to Geralt's character. So him even being okay with a ceremony this savage, I don't like the idea of it. It just doesn't make sense to me. But you know, this is the route it seems like they may or may not go. We'll have to wait and see. But, you know, yeah, it just don't sound like it's going to end up well to me. That's all I'm saying. Now, there's a lot of stuff going on with season two, like some weird choices they've made with some of the female actors apparently coming up. There's something in there about Queen Maeve being younger than she was in the books, which doesn't sound like something too bad. Then there was another thing about Francesca being pregnant. That's going to be a whole nother video. I gotta make a video about the sorcerers and how much the show has messed them up, because in all honesty, if that's true, that's just another big though. Like, what are you guys doing? Like, that's completely against everything in the lore. But you know, I'll leave it to rest. Anyway, tell me what you guys are thinking about this. How are you feeling about Witcher Netflix and some of the changes they've made so far? I like the show, but man, I'm just not feeling some of this stuff the way they're laying it down. But who knows, maybe they'll make a lot of improvements that we were hoping to see in season two on top of all this stuff. And who knows, maybe they'll execute all this a lot better than any of us thought they could. So we'll just have to wait and see. Let me know what you guys think. Leave likes and comments and all that good stuff down below. And hit the subscribe button. I will see you guys on the next one. ZFR out, you guys.